shall say unto the elders of his city, this is our son, is stubborn and rebellious, and he will not obey our voice. He is a glutton and a drunkard, drug user, abuser. Amen. And all the men of his city shall stone him with stones, that he die. So shall thou put evil away from among you, and all Israel shall hear and fear. Let us stand. Everybody stand up. Father God, we just thank you right now in the mighty name of Jesus for this word that's coming forth, Father. We just ask you that it be mild to our bones, corrections to our body, and help us to die of self. Help us to do your will in all things, Lord God. Let the speaker decrease so that you may increase. Let me walk on the word of your word. Let us know that we don't need to be shameful today. Let us realize that there was a time you would have killed each and every one of us just because of our drug addiction, because of our disobedience, and because of our rebelliousness against our parents, against our leaders, against anything that was not ordained unto you. So, Father, thank you for your grace. Thank you for your humbleness, and thank you for your power. In Christ Jesus' name, let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Have a seat. All right. I guess that was a little shocking to me as well. Amen? That was a wake-up call, wasn't it? Your parents could take you to the elders of the city and just say, you know what, we're going to know what you're doing. Look at God's grace. Just because you got high. Just because you said no, mommy. Just because you said no, daddy. You were taken to the city and stoned to death. Today, boy, look at the grace of God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We should have all been dead a million times over. Yeah. Because thou shalt not kill does not mean thou shalt not murder. But killing someone that brings a spirit to land, God killed a whole lot of folks. God killed children. God killed animals. Because he said, wipe out every single thing. That's where Samuel and Saul were disobedient because he took the spirit of the land when God said, kill a man, woman, child, and beast. Because demons could be brought into the camp even through animals. Okay? And God don't want nothing evil being brought in. And if you don't know that, just read the story about the man at the tombs, because the demons said, let's go into those pigs. And the pigs weren't even sleeping up there, the demons there, and they weren't drowning. So. Amen. Okay. Now, because see, we a pig is smarter than us not to have a demon. Ain't that deep? But yeah, we carry them all the time. Without a problem. But a pig said, what's that? Amen. Let's talk about shame a little bit. Before we get into the word real good. Alright? Understanding shame. Shame is defined as feeling bad about who you are. Now we got a lot to feel bad about because when we get into that drug addiction and we spend up the money, we did this, we abuse the kids, we didn't buy the diapers, we didn't buy the food, what is it? Shame. You know, when we cheat on the wife or do something stupid, what is it? Shame. If we wind up with gonorrhea and take it back to our woman, who winds up? Shame. Amen? You know, we don't show up on the job, and our boss gave us chance after chance after chance. And what did he do? He had to fire us because he gave us too many chances. What happened? Shame. Amen? And that's where the devil really wants to destroy you. Now, shame and guilt is different. I mean, shame and guilt. Shame is different from guilt. How? Guilt says, I did something bad that I should not have done. I feel guilty about it. I spent the check. Baby, I'll make it up. Please. You know, I'll be out there hustling it back. Alright? But then shame says, I did something bad, therefore I am a bad person. And that's where the enemy wants to get you to think that you're bad, you're not worthy. You know, God won't forgive me. Amen? I can't make it again. He wants to get you to that place of self-defeat. And when he gets you to that place of self-defeat, he can destroy you. But we know that through the grace and the blood of Christ, that we are always forgiven. That's why I look at new grace every morning. Amen? Brand new grace. Amen. Forget what I did. Thank God. I ain't got to be stoned today. I just plead the blood and I'm forgiven. Amen? Alright.
Shame-related behavior. There are several behaviors common to an adult suffering from shame. And what are they?
Denial. That's the main place you're going to be at.
Knock.
Yeah, admit your condition. Don't accept your identity. Identity is always here, but admit your condition. That's your first move in your healing. Saying, I do have this problem. And always acknowledging it. Because when you keep it seated, the devil can use it against you. Isolation. I don't want to talk to nobody. Most men get like that. I don't want to talk to nobody. I'm a cheap client, man. I handle it myself. That's pride. That's pride. Alright? And that will cause you being more ashamed because you don't even want to come out and look nobody in the eye. Perfectionism. I'm going to wait until I get it all right. I'm sorry to tell you, you ain't going to get it all right. Alright? Don't be waiting because you won't get there. There ain't no perfect person on this earth, I don't care who they are, who's going to have it right. until we go home and be with the Lord. You are not going to be perfect. Just deal with what you got right now and keep moving forward. Because every time you get something right, he's going to show you what is wrong so you can get that right. Then he's going to show you what else is wrong so you can get that right. That's what it's ever doing, ever learning and ever moving and ever teaching. Amen? These are some of the SRTs you can use for shame. As you see, I'm moving fast because I want to get into this message that God gave me. Amen? Amen. And it's all on courage because I want to build you up today. This is maybe my last class for y'all. Amen? So, God bless y'all. Pray for me. Sister Vicky, me and her, I'm prayed about it. She won't be down here any longer. Okay? And I'll back the people in my ministry. All right? But anyway, because I don't teach. This is what I teach. I don't get off my level. No problem with the program. I love everybody. There's no hurt feelings, no bitterness, no nothing like that. I always remain in my level. Plus, I teach in a lot of other places too, so. So, but one of the things I want to get you to understand is special options we carried before, which is obey, pray, and submit. But this is how you're going to be able to defeat the enemy. Amen? And because you are in crisis and fallible army, you're part of CIA. Everybody knows those military terms, right? And sin, whenever you rail on sin, that means self indeed. You're being selfish. Weren't we selfish in our addiction? It was only about us and for us. We even might have had the right mind and the right heart about, you know, I'm going to go back and take care of the family. I'm going to spend the money. But as soon as that thing hits, one's too many, and a thousand and enough. Even though our hearts said we want to do the right thing. Because men got, in our heart of hearts, we want to be providers. We are made to be providers. We are made to be workers. If we ain't doing something wrong. No man should feel comfortable about sitting around. You know what I mean? Because we wouldn't make up like that. God didn't make us like that. He made us to be productive people. Amen? Ego. That's your pride level. Anytime you start thinking selfish, you lose God. You're completely out of the will of God. I don't care who you are. When pride steps in, you're out of the will of God. Amen? You are totally out of the will of God. God leads you to yourself. I don't want to be left to myself because I'll kill me. You know what I mean? I always got to make sure. I'm too weak. I am. My strength comes from the Lord. Amen? Here are some of the weapons that you can use, submission and submit. That's hard for many people. You know? That's where humility takes place. Alright? Still ain't gonna let nobody talk to you in your kind of way. You know, that's still being a man. I'm a soldier. You know what I mean? That's what my position is in Christ. I ain't one of those peaceful carriers. No, I fight. I'm on the front line. I'm a soldier for the Lord. Amen? Even though there are certain weapons, I can show you scriptures in the Word of God that says, thou shalt not kill, this is right. But God always said you need to protect yourself and protect life. And if that means lead to murder or killing someone in warfare, you better know it. Even Jesus said, when I leave, you better go sell your coat and buy a sword. And back in those days, the sword was the most powerful weapon they used. So what's that weapon powerful you today? Using your handgun, Glock, whatever. But that's to protect your family and protect you. You don't walk with nobody with you, right? But if somebody tried to kill you and kill your family, you have every right not to kill them. Sorry. Thou shalt not kill. No, that's all. Well, turning the other cheek is only for the gospel's sake. Study the background. Why would Jesus say, when I leave here, go sell your coat and buy a sword? Because he knows you're going to be fighting for your life. But you are not supposed to take violence from people. You know what I mean? Like the pro-lifers who go out and blow up places and stuff like that. No, that's God's judgment. That ain't ours. You know, because somebody's gay. Am I supposed to hate them? No. God gives consent, but not the sinner. All right? Well, we're the judge. But every time we judge somebody like that, guess what the judgment falls on? Us. You know, they would rather accept a gay person before they accept one of you in our nation. You realize that. They hate you more than they hate that gay or homosexual person. Why? Because they feel like they can't trust you. You can steal from them. You're no God on good. You're the wretched of good. We're actually the most powerful army God has, especially in these end times together. That's why we can only relate to each other. When we go to the church, they can't relate to us. They don't even want to hear it. They forgot where they came from. And they pit us against each other. That should not be. That's why I love teaching the kind of people that been through what I've been through. Because they can talk real to you. I can bring it to you and I can relate to you. Amen? Amen. But religious folk can't do it. You can be like, why these people understand? Because they don't want to. They want to forget. You're recognized. You're a mirror to what their problem is. Okay, let me put it like that. That's why you can't be in denial. Always stand up for who you are and let the blood of Christ cover you. Amen? Amen. Alright, here's obedience and obey. Still, that's a problem of being able to humble ourselves and be humility. But this is how we win the war here against pride and ego. Because as long as the devil can keep you prideful, he can destroy you. That's what he wants, because he was prideful. You know, lust of the eye, lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. If I keep you focused on that, I can get you.
This is only three weapons, even though they're vast, but they're only three. So what is our main weapon? Study to die to self. Think of your brother morning, think of yourself.
I know that's hard.
It's all breaking what we used to do. God wants to take us out of our comfort.